In 5000 BC, a hunter's skull was cracked open. Bone pressing into brain? Seizures. By every modern standard, he was a dead man. But someone operated with a rock, and he survived. In 1865, doctors at the New York Academy of Medicine examined an ancient skull from Peru. Square hole, clean edges, they laughed. Done after death, they said. A ritual. In their own hospitals, survival rates for head surgery were near zero. If a Victorian gentleman got a hole in his head, he died. But a French surgeon looked closer. The edges weren't sharp. They were smooth, rounded, callous formation. The bone had grown back. The patient lived for years after the surgery. The surgeon had no degree, no sterile theater, no antibiotics. He had obsidian, volcanic glass. When flaked correctly, sharper than any modern steel scalpel, down to the molecule. He washed the blade in fire, gave the patient herbs to dull the senses. Then he began. Not a cut, a scrape, slow, rhythmic, scrape, 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 for hours, grinding through bone without touching the membrane beneath. One slip, the patient dies. He worked by firelight, feeling the depth by vibration alone. The bone came free. The pressure released. The seizures stopped. And the patient woke up. We don't know their names. We don't have their techniques. We just have skulls with holes and edges that healed. Proof they did something we couldn't replicate for thousands of years. In the American Civil War, survival rate for a head wound was roughly 10% in ancient Peru. With stone tools and plant medicine, survival rate was over 80%. They were safer with a rock in a cave than a soldier was in a modern field hospital. We think we invented precision medicine. We just rediscovered it. And we still don't know what they used to stop the infection.